Hey everyone, it's Ray from the Teach Better team, and I am with the amazing Eric Curts. How are you?
Hey, I am doing fantastic. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of the Mastery Chat tonight.
Oh my gosh, you just hosted Mastery Chat like 11 minutes ago. We just ended. Are you still on this high of like, oh my gosh, we just hosted an hour chat over on Twitter and there were so many things discussed?
Yeah, I mean, that was the thing. It's just the amount of resources being shared. I would, you know, I'm doing my best to use, you know, TweetDeck to try to, you know, keep things organized. And I'll see something I like and I go, oh, I want to click on that. By the time my mouse gets there, it's moved down the screen and there's three more resources that have come in.
Every week it's so crazy. But for you to say that, I mean, geez, it really was an amazing chat. And the resources we're going to have to talk all about, because it seemed like this chat was chock full of resources, tools, like takeaways teachers can literally go put into their classroom tomorrow.
Right.
So before we get into all that fun, we could say hi to Neil Gupta. Hello, glad you're in here. Eric, would you mind kind of sharing what's your background? Like, what do you do in education? And then eventually, maybe that will lead to why you picked today's topic for a Mastery Chat.
Well, I'm in my 28th year in education. Started off as a middle school math teacher and taught middle school math for about 7 years. Yeah, got to remember now. It's been a long time ago. Taught eighth grade math and a little bit of seventh grade math for 7 years and loved it. Absolutely loved doing that. But I also loved technology. And so I was sort of the building nerd. You know, if something went wrong with the printer, go see Eric. You know, if you needed to know how to do something. And this was way back. Like, I mean, we didn't really even have much technology, but I still was absolutely, you know, just obsessed with it. And around that time, so a good 21 years ago, at the end of my seventh year of teaching, we got a position posted in our district, which is pretty common now, a tech integration position, like a tech coach. But it was pretty new back then. And the idea was we had all this technology, and now what do we do with it? And it seemed like a really good fit for me. So I moved from teaching students to teaching teachers, and I've been doing that ever since. I stayed at that district for another 14 years in that role. And then the last 7 years, I've been doing the same thing, but at the county office. So I still serve that same school district. I just serve about 35 school districts up in Northeast Ohio. And of course, they have their own tech people as well. I'm just helping serve from a county level. And a lot of what I focus on is googly things. All of our districts, every school district that we serve, they're all G Suite districts. And so that is something we all have in common, no matter what, you know, different devices we might use, or some schools are urban and some are suburban and some are big and some are small, and we're all different. But a thread that connects us all together is the free suite of Google tools. And so I do a lot of work with the school districts, supporting them in that as to, you know, creative ways to use these tools. So whether I'm going out to the districts or they're coming into me, or I'm putting things on the blog, and that's really what the whole Control Alt Achieve blog is about, is just things that I end up working on for the schools that I work with on a daily basis. I'm like, well, maybe other people would like these things. And so I share them out on the blog as well so that other folks can benefit from them. And so that's my day job. I mean, I do on the side travel around and do conferences and trainings and keynotes and things like that. But, you know, that is my day job. And then as much as I can, I try to travel around as a Google trainer as well.
Geez, it makes sense, because today's chat was all about tools.
Yeah. We were looking, the main idea of the chat today was creative uses of the tools. It's like, okay, we've got all these Google tools. We've got docs and sheets and slides and drawings and maps. And a lot of times we'll be familiar with them and we'll say, yeah, that's great. You know, Google Docs is a word processor, you know, Google Slides is a multimedia presentation tool.
Yeah.
But the idea was we were going to do a MacGyver Google type of a theme for this tonight, which was, okay, so how else can you use these tools? Yes, Google Slides is a multimedia slideshow tool, but it's also a stop motion animation creation tool. And it's a great tool for student collaborative writing. And it's a great tool for making eBooks. And it's a great tool for drag and drop manipulative activities. And that was the whole idea, was trying to say, okay, you've got, you know, these tools that we're used to using one way, how else can we use it? And I kind of hoped that theme made sense and followed through, because my very first question with the introduction was, I said, you know, everybody introduce yourself. Who are you? What do you do? And list a creative way to use a screwdriver. You know, so that was part of the introduction thing. And there were some really creative suggestions, but that's what I was trying
to. Did you have a favorite that people shared? Because that got a ton of activity.
That got so many of them. I mean, there were some awesome ones, like somebody was talking about using it to chip ice, which, being here in Ohio, I'm like, yes, I understand. I have chipped ice with that. But yeah, people were so creative with their suggestions on, but that's what I was hoping to tap into is, yeah, we've got this thing, it's designed for putting screws in and out. But what are all the ways we can use it, from people talking about prying open paint cans to, you know, using it as a microphone to sing into, to do, you know, whatever. I mean, it can be used for so many other things. And that was, I was hoping, was going to be the mindset we would take into the chat tonight, is let's look at these tools that maybe we just take for granted and we're just so used to using them, and say, okay, let's kind of look at it from a different angle and say how, but that's what educators do. And we always do that. We take what nobody ever intended sometimes to be an educational tool. I mean, think of Twitter, just Twitter itself. You know, I really, you know, that was not the initial idea. And educators have in many ways, you know, co-opted it and taken over it. And that's what we do with tools. But we have to as well, because a lot of schools are struggling with budgets. And, you know, the G Suite of tools are free. And so it's like, okay, maybe we can't afford to buy certain software, but let's use the tools we have in creative ways to address those needs.
Man, you just touched on so many important things. But I think the above all message that I hope everyone takes away from this is that there was epic ideas and resources shared for tools that I use every single day, just not in the way that people were suggesting. So there was so many different, you know, brainstorming sessions for teachers, whether it was using something for like a Google Sheets as classroom management tool, Google Slides as manipulatives, or I mean, every single tool had some sort of use that was brand new that I had never thought of before.
Right. Yes.
Did you have a favorite question that you asked that you thought would might like stir up some great conversation? Or did you have a question in mind that you specifically said, wow, this stirred up way more conversation than I expected?
Well, I mean, I'm always kind of feeling that things like Google Sheets and Google Drawings may not get a lot of love, because they're not, Google Drawings isn't as well known, and Google Sheets people sometimes get scared of, like, you know, oh, it's a spreadsheet program. I was very pleasantly surprised to see the responses we got for those. You know, I'm expecting a lot of creative things with slides and docs, and I was really happy to see that. But we did have a few people when we mentioned Sheets were like saying, yeah, I am not as familiar with that. And same thing with Drawings. But there were so many good ideas that were mentioned, you know, people talking about, you know, using Google Sheets and using conditional formatting to make a self-grading quiz. Somebody had that shared in there as well. And people talking about using Google Drawings to, you know, create. I think somebody was talking about they were making pictures for books they had read, I think, and they were using it. But so many ideas on tools that in the past, I think, would not have gotten as much feedback. And that was encouraging. I was really glad to see that there was a lot of folks that are using these tools a lot more than have been using them in the past. Yeah.
Absolutely. I saw so many. And even just in our comments right now, people are saying that they love the creativity. They felt like the how else was an awesome start, and also could be a really good theme to foster creativity and innovation. Adam says that he loved the chat. So I think everyone really loved the challenge that you provided to really require educators to think out of the box, even though we are so close to winter break, but really think out of the box in terms of how we can, you know, use the tools that we have accessible at our fingertips as teachers.
Right. And the creativity is an important point. You know, we talk a lot about the four C's, or however many C's you want to count in there. But, you know, creativity, collaboration, critical thinking, communication. We're talking about these tools, and we're talking about really using them for student learning and student creativity. And yes, we can absolutely talk as well about how these are good for classroom management, and that's wonderful. There were a lot of really good ideas shared on that as well. But I was so excited to see how many things were shared about these being student projects. You know, I know one thing I share a lot of times when it comes to Google Drawings is one that Julie Lyle came up with. And so she does this thing where she has the kids make mosaics by taking an image, putting it into Google Drawings, and then taking like triangles or squares and covering the image with them and coloring them in, and then getting rid of the original image and just having this mosaic as a result. And I saw Julie jumped in the chat and shared that as well tonight. And that's one of the ones that I share from her when I talk about drawings a lot. But that emphasizes the whole point. It's about students using the tools and doing something creative with it. So that they're making something, not just, you know, the technology being something that is doing a productivity task, which is great. I mean, that's wonderful. I love using technology, of course, to make things simpler so we have more time to do what we do best, connect with kids, spend time working one-on-one with them and not just, you know, grading papers or working with data. So it's great that it does that. But I love the emphasis tonight on the student creativity with all of these different projects.
Absolutely. Joe just commented he would love to see you tackle a chat on Keynote, highly underutilized tool. So he's talking about the tool Keynote. Have you ever used it?
No, I have not.
No, well, that will be the next one. Put in to-do list, right?
Oh, my goodness. And I do. And I have we all have that to-do list. And there were a lot of tools mentioned tonight that I'm like, yeah. Like one of the questions was, what is some of the lesser known Google tools? And somebody was talking about Jamboard. And I've used Jamboard, but it's one of those things where it's like, you know, I just really need to take the time to just dig into it, because you don't have to have a physical Jamboard. You can just use the Jamboard, you know, website, the web app, and have most all of the features there. And it's those sort of things you see and you're like, yeah, I've got the to-do list of one that's like, I just need to lock myself in a room and just dig into this tool and really, you know, explore it. And so I was encouraged by a lot of the things that I saw there tonight that reminded me of tools that I want to dig into. So, yeah, hey, learn something new every day. I mean, that's the thing. We, you know, we're all going to be lifelong learners. So
it's true. Whenever I find that I put a tech tool on my to-do list and I can't get to it, like within like a week, if I can't get to it, my immediate go-to is like, why am I exploring this tool? I'm going to hand it to one of my sixth graders, because I teach sixth grade math. I'm going to hand it to one of my students and they're going to tell me what they think, how we can use it. That's just that sometimes they're the best brainstorming buddies.
Yep, absolutely. And that's an important thing. We don't have to be experts. We don't have to have everything figured out with these tools before we use them with our students. Okay. You know enough, of course, that you're not setting yourself up for failure, but let the students explore and let them teach each other. Let them discover things, because somebody will find a neat feature in drawings or slides and it will just spread through the classroom as they figure out how to use it. And that's wonderful. Again, it shows that growth mindset to our students, saying that we are learners, we are constant, and that's okay. We don't have to be experts on these things. We can all learn together.
Yeah, you know, Eric, you shared a lot of tools that I want to touch on really quick. It seemed like for every question, you had some sort of free blog that a teacher could go explore and go find out new ways or uses that they could implement these tools into their classroom. And what I loved is that really sparked other teachers sharing resources that they had as well, which I think just fostered an amazing community of not only learning and, you know, talking about technology, but really discussing the tangible ways that we can actually go into school tomorrow and implement these resources, not just as this, you know, hypothetical echo chamber of best practice, but how do we actually take that and put it in our classroom? Would you mind kind of telling us a little bit more about, if somebody visited your blog site, what can they expect? What can they get? Why should they be bookmarking it as a constant visit?
Sure. That was definitely something I was hoping would help spur some ideas. So yes, for each of the tools, I did link in maybe four or so blog posts for each one of them, so that people could have something they can go to and use, like you said, tomorrow. So the blog is Control Alt Achieve, and just controlaltachieve.com. And when you get there, there's a couple of different sections. Of course, there's the main page, which is the blog, which is chronological. And that's great. You can just, you know, read down through that. But because there's so much content on the site now, one thing that you could also do is there's a second tab, which is the resources tab. And that tab has each of the different Google tools listed. And if you click on those, it pulls together all the blog posts and all the resources for each tool. That's pretty much what we were doing tonight when we were talking about creative ways to use, you know, docs. And I was talking about blackout poetry, or I was talking about choose your own adventure stories, or I was talking about using emoji activities in docs. Every one of those, I have a blog post for those. And if you go to the site, you go to resources, you go to docs, boom, there they are. And if you, you know, there's explanations, little help videos, templates, things like that. So you can just turn right around and use those right away. And so that would be, if you were trying to tap into what we were doing tonight in the chat, probably the resource tab. The resources tab on the Control Alt Achieve blog is the easiest way to get to the docs, sheets, slides, you know, drawings page, maps page, where I have all of those resources pulled together for people to use. And everything there, of course, is free to use and reuse any way you want. You know, if you want to use it with your students, if you want to modify it, that's fantastic. Recently, I'd done a bunch of Christmas activities. That's ones, well, holiday activities, not specifically Christmas, but holiday activities. And I added a new one this year. So it was up like 7 activities. And somebody said, hey, would you mind? Could I take these and port them over to the Microsoft tools? And I said, absolutely. You know, everything's released Creative Commons license, do whatever, you know, just make sure you keep it free. And they said, sure. And so they made, you know, a PowerPoint version of my slides activities, you know, and a Word version of my docs activities. Wonderful. That means more kids are getting to, you know, try out these ideas and come home from school and share something they're excited about doing in school today. So, yeah.
So important. You know, Eric, if there was one thing that you wanted educators to take away from Mastery Chat this week, one thing in that full hour, what do you hope that they walked away from that chat after being exhausted because they were so busy and there was so much resources shared and holy moly, but what's the one thing that you're like, I really hope that all the educators who are now hopefully either relaxing watching this video or spending some time with family, what's the takeaway?
Well, I think it really goes back to realizing that technology is not an end in itself. It's a tool. It's a means to an end. The end is education. The end is student creativity. Technology, let's not get caught up. Now, yeah, we talk about Google tools a lot, but don't get caught up in the fact that it was, you know, Google tools. Like I said, a lot of these can be done in the Microsoft tools, or they can be done with Canva, or they can be done with Powtoon, or they can be done with something else. The idea is, let's not get hung up on technology as being the end. It is the means. It is the tool. And once we think of it as a tool, like a screwdriver, then we can get creative. Our students can get creative. We can think of other ways to use it, because our end result isn't, oh, I need to use this tool in my class. It's, I need my students to create. I need them to think critically. I need them to work together. What's a good tool that helps support that? And so that's what I was hoping we were getting across with those examples tonight.
I think that was so clear, and I love that you summarized it perfectly right there. I think that educators are continuously working on this mindset of really seeing technology as something that they should be utilizing in their classroom, making it very purposeful, and you provided so many good ideas for them. So thank you for sharing your insight for a whole hour on Mastery Chat. You have no idea how valuable you are as a part of our Teach Better family, so we really appreciate you.
It was my honor, and I really appreciate being allowed to take part in it. Thank you so much.
Awesome. For everybody listening, don't forget, Master Chat is every single Thursday. We never cancel. Every single Thursday at 7 o'clock Central, 8 o'clock Eastern. Next week, the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Jeff Gargis, is hosting on the 26th. So we hope that you come join us. Eric, thank you again for sharing your insight. We're so fortunate to be connected with you, and we hope that all of our Mastery Chat family members and Teach Better Network choose to connect with you and just continue to grow from all of your insight. And bookmark your blog, because there's so much there. You'll want to revisit it 1,000 times. So thank you again, Eric, and we'll see you guys later.